Oh yeah! Double shock. Hey, what's up everybody? My name is Trophinet and welcome back to Horizon Zero Dawn. Hello. We're almost back to the man that we helped his daughter off. So we helped Arana to get out of those watchers. And then we killed a few scrappers and got her mother's spear back. So her dead mother's spear back. I'm just going to quickly save at the campfire here and continue on. I do think that we now unlocked scrappers on the map, because I encountered a few. You probably saw that in the combat compilation I made.
Back with the spear.
And you're talking to me for some reason.
First you send Arana back to me, and now you've got the spear.
Yes, indeed we have.
When I first called out to you for help, I didn't even know if you'd speak to me. I'm glad you did.
Well, it's obviously usually the other way around.
I can't believe you got the spear back.
They usually don't talk to us.
It's of exceptional make.
I'll never be the crafter she was, but she did pass along a few tricks. I'd be happy to take a look at your spear.
Yes, please.
It sounds like she was special. I'm sorry for your loss.
Well, because of you, I still have the spear to remember her by. You didn't have to help us, but you did. She would have admired that. Thank you, Aloy, for everything.
You're welcome. So, in her mother's footsteps completed. So that means we now have an upgraded spear. Yeah, a spear damage boost. Thank you very much. I think I do need to make some more ammo for the trip caster. Yeah, and for the normal bow. Maybe a few more fire arrows as well. Now that we're fully up again, I'm going to quickly save. And then I think it's high time we move back to... Let's check the quest log. So we could talk to Ross. The only thing we still have left is the getting the... Well, the necklace back to old Grata. But I think I'm just going to wait with that and just head on with Mother's Heart. So that's already selected. Let's head to crafting and see if I can't upgrade. Yeah, weapon satchel. Don't really need to upgrade that, I think, for now. Other than that, we still have those modifications. How do I actually, or can't I apply that yet? Because I don't really have had a tutorial yet. There's more in this. Thank you very much. Still have a few health potions in there left. And then, oh, I can craft these. How? So I have only one of these potions, but I have two in the... Ah, there we go. If I just take, I can get those other potions. And then we have skills. 1 point left, but I'm going to save up for heavy lifter. And then for extra concentration. There we go. Freeze rhyme root, can't really use that. Corruption glaze root, and this is fire. So, yeah, nothing of use here. But we're really close to where we need to be right now as well. Accidentally, because I didn't really plan this out. But Mother's Heart to the right... That was overkill. I think it died. God damn it. Search the fox. Thank you, fatty meat. Probably shouldn't kill animals with fire arrows. Probably not good for the meat inside. Oh, although it might be roasted immediately. I do love the music as well, by the way. Because it's this... It's kind of a combination of electronic and... More conventional... Rival-like music, maybe even. God damn it. Stop running away from me! There we go. Boar dead. Oh, it's being dragged along. No, 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 no. That's my boar. That's my boar. Whew. Don't want to lose that rich meat. Anything else in here? Doesn't seem like there is anything aside from a turkey waddling around over there. Well, we need to go in here, so... Mother's Heart, yes. So that's the village we've passed by before. I'm wondering how this will pan out, because I think we're heading right into the main event. So the proving. Bunny, bunny. I'm distracted. Fire bunny. let's gather all that up. Thank you very much. And then let's head into the town, I presume. Yeah, there's Rost. Hello.
We must speak.
Okay.
So, it's time.
That sounded ready? Really serious. Yes, I'm ready.
Yes, I guess. It's louder than I expected.
Louder?
I've been so close before.
I guess everything's bigger up close.
Soon it'll all seem familiar. Like home.
If we win.
How about that?
Look for High Matriarch Tirsa. She'll help you. Any other concerns?
So Tirsa is the matriarch that blessed us at the beginning of the game, the very beginning of the game, at the naming of Aloy. And he lost advice.
Any final lessons before I head in?
No. You've learned every lesson the Wilds have to teach.
It was you who taught me, not the Wilds. Not sure my bow and spear will be much help in there, though.
It is with bow and spear that you'll win what you've wanted all these years, Aloy. Answers.
Fair enough. Mother's heart.
What should I expect once I'm inside?
There'll be people celebrating and feasting. More than you've ever seen in one
place. Okay, so he does know how it's inside.
Compares to Mother's Heart. It is the seat of the High Matriarchs, a center of Nora life, a jewel of the sacred land. Give it time, and you'll grow fond of it. As I was, back when I was at the tribe.
So I wasn't really clear on that, but it's clear that he was part of the tribe before, but became an outcast somewhere in between then and now.
Are you sure they're gonna let me in?
I've told you, Aloy. By law, any child outcast can run in the proving.
And any who pass are made braves and are outcasts no more. I know that.
So only child
not
outcasts.
Everyone follows the law like you do, Rost.
Have faith, Aloy. The tribe will honor your right.
Okay, then. We'll have to, yeah, we'll have to trust in you, then. I'm all set.
I'm ready to do this. See you back home in a few days?
You will not find me there, Aloy. Here.
Come on, Rost.
Take
where are you gonna go?
Remember.
What is it? What is it?
Why are you talking like we'll never see each other again? No. No!
You should be with the tribe. And I will always be an outcast.
But I told you, I have that figured out. I'll come to you in secret. I'll be the one breaking the law, not you. You don't even have to talk to me.
This attachment to me will only hold you back. It's my wish that you embrace the tribe. You've lived in isolation long enough.
Not until now, I didn't.
For your sake, I must go where you will never find me. This is goodbye.
Come on, Ross, don't do this. I understand, but I will find you, then good riddance. I will find you, Ross.
No, it's not. You taught me how to track. Wherever you go, I can follow.
Not this time.
Yes, this we time. Will.
And every time. I'll be wearing this when I find you.
May All Mother bless you, Aloy.
Wow, they started with the heart-wrenching really soon.
And you.
It's only episode 4, guys. Take it easy. Whew, okay.
I have to let him go. For now.
Okay. Let's enter Mother's Heart.
After that, I'll see where his trail leads.
The Proving. I'm really curious what we're gonna have to do in the Proving. Because I have the feeling that everybody survives, but somehow they
you
declare a winner.
Outcast.
No, we will not.
Or bleed. Your choice.
I can kick your ass as well if you want to.
Make way! Make way!
Ah, there's Tirsa.
Braves, stand aside. She is welcome here. Mother's heart is open to you, child. Come. I assure you, most Nora aren't so rude as those idiots.
You're Tirsa?
Who else would I be? Come on now. I've been waiting for this day a long time.
So...
Oh, yes.
I'm assuming this is 20 years further.
I must leave you. I have other outsiders to keep safe tonight.
You what?
She looks...
Envoys from another tribe, the Karja. Come to observe improving, and oh, how the Nora hate the Karja.
Karja?
But that's my problem. We will talk later. In the meantime, enjoy the festival. Oh, down the path to the right, you'll find an old friend who can't wait to see you.
But I don't know anyone here.
Try telling him that. We will talk later. May the goddess protect.
So that might be Tab then. So Tab is the guy we saved when we were little. There we go. Had a bit of a network glitch. So that was interesting. So Tirsa doesn't look a year older than she looked at the beginning of the game. And we had to meet somebody who's eager to see us again. The only two guys I can remember is Artab, the guy we saved when we were little, and Bast, the kid that threw rocks at our face at the beginning of the game. What is that? What is this? Interact. Somebody gonna do anything about that? Hello? No? Is that it? Huh.
This heat crawls.
I've been up since early in the morning. I can barely think.
They are talking.
It's you, isn't it? Over here.
There we go. Tab. Hello, Tab.
It is Aloy, isn't it? I'm remembering your name correctly.
Are you the old friend Tirsa told me about? I don't know you.
You do.
I see you don't recognize me. Well, it was a long time ago. Teb is my name. You were half my size when you saved me from a herd of machines.
I remember. You tried to thank me.
I never forgot that day. All these years, I hope to see you again, if you came to run in the proving. As you can see, I didn't turn out to be much of a hunter. I served the tribe as a stitcher instead. A maker of garments and armor.
Sounds like somebody I want to make a visit.
In preparation for this day, I've made an outfit for you. I hope you like it.
What's it going to cost?
Yeah, I think I will. You're
cost
pretty enthusiastic,
nothing.
Are you?
Consider the thanks I tried to give years ago. Long overdue.
He didn't age a bit either. This must be about 15 years later for him, so... That is interesting. Nora Brave. A new Nora Brave's armor stitched by Tab, accentuated by Aloy's own designs, offer no extra protection but can be upgraded. Nora Survivor Light. All a bit pricey. So let's just go for Nora Brave for now. Thank you very much. Equip. Equip, yes. Yeah, looks pretty nice, so... Anything else? Do you have... Oh, you have a free sample box as well. Thank you! And maybe I should sell a few things to you. You know what? Let's just keep it like that. We have a lot of capacity right now, so...
Seems to fit you perfectly.
Thank you, Teb. I've never had anything like this before.
Well, it's yours. I think you'll find it affords more protection than what you were wearing.
That's
Every
not what the game told
offers
me.
Some advantage. It's always a trade-off. Anyway, I shouldn't keep you any longer. Head for the Matriarch's Lodge if you want to find Tirsa. You'll know it when you see it. A large wooden building with an angry mob waiting outside.
Tirsa said something about envoys from another tribe?
The Karja.
Yes, that's what the mob's angry about. Karja visiting our sacred land for the first time in years. I'd expect to see some tomatoes fly, maybe rocks. Hopefully not spears. In any case, be ready to duck.
Duck. Where's the duck? I want to kill some duck. So I could trade with Tab, but I'm not going to. I am going to check the inventory screen for those treasure boxes. Two metal vessels, a fast travel pack, and a resist fire potion. Thank you very much. So, I'm gonna assume that every guy has that. Well, I can sit here.
Interesting.
Yeah, very interesting. But we're going to move on. Yeah, okay, there we go. Not going to greet, so yeah, that's fire again. Can't really do anything about that.
Get down from there. Bad enough you're drunk. Why do you have to go climbing houses?
Oh, not supposed to go climbing on other people's roofs, huh?
What the hell are you doing up there?
Get down from there, now!
Oh, that's just what you want, isn't it? For me to fall on my head!
What I want is for you to climb down!
What you want is for me to have no fun at all!
Came from all my...
Fine! Stay up on the roof all night if you want!
Yeah, I will!
All were her children. They lived alongside each other in the comfort of her wild embrace. But some grew restless. Though they took of her bounty, they wanted more. These were the Faithless.
Listen to the backstory.
The machines whispered to them, promised to serve them, to make them a new world, better than the one All Mother provided. A world of metal. They told the Faithless they would do all the work for them. Feed them, shelter them, give them a life of ease. Of plenty. And so, the Faithless left with the machines. Only the true children, the mothers and fathers of the Nora, stayed with All Mother. At first, the machines did as they had promised. They built cities, great and terrible, monuments to their sins. But they would not serve the Faithless for long. A king rose up among the machines. A machine more powerful than any other. The Metal Devil. And then the Faithless served him, served the machines. That was not enough for the Metal Devil. He wanted all to serve him and tried to tempt the true children away from All Mother. They would not go. They gathered on the mountainside to cling to her and prayed, more devoted than ever.
This is a long story.
The Metal Devil raged louder than thunder. In his fury, he came to confront All Mother, intending to kill her. She struck him down. Forever. As you know, for his lifeless body is up there still, frozen in shame and defeat.
Oh.
The machines were driven mad by the death of their king, and their minds
that thing
became
over
as
there.
Wild as beasts. The Faithless abandoned their cities, forced to wander the world without the care of the machines. Only we remain the true children of All Mother. We built all this with the hands that she gave us. Machines are to be hunted. Metal to be used for scrap, for craft, but never to be adored. And we stay true to her laws, resolute in our prayers, don't we? For the dangers are never over. Still, the Faithless envy our sacred land and covet it. And year upon year, the machine's anger grows, searching for little Nora boys and girls who have not behaved.
What? Is that a machine among us now?
No. Huh. These old guys are mistaken.
You remember that brave got drunk and
so that is interesting. So she mentions that there was a split early on between the people. So we had the Faithless that went with the machines and then the people who worshipped the All Mother. And that thing over there is the king of the machines, or was the king of the machines. But we kind of know that her story is not completely right, because at the beginning of the game, when Aloy fell in that pit,
Aloy, over here.
She kinda already discovered that something else happened. Why those people? Because those people just
Come
died
over,
in their
Aloy.
Place. Yeah, hello, Karst.
Karst? What are you doing here?
Careful. Pretend like we've never met. I wasn't supposed to trade with outcasts in the wilds, remember?
Yeah, indeed.
How could I forget? And how generous of you to talk to me now.
Don't be like that. You know I'll be rooting for you in the proving tomorrow.
So the proving is tomorrow.
Looks at some of these
interesting.
Faces when you win. And if you need any last-minute supplies, I'm your man.
Okay, why
so,
did you come?
Mother's heart. I thought you preferred the wilds.
Well, a man can't drink alone all the time, can he? Truth is, I get lonely once in a while. There, I admitted it. Don't think less of me.
I won't hold it against you, if you give me a discount.
You can't be.
I'm joking, Karst. It's good to see you.
Don't go soft on me.
I kind of feel like I know his voice from somewhere, but yeah, let's try.
I'll give you my best prices, I promise.
I don't know if your promise is worth much. I'm wondering if I should, because it doesn't seem like he upgraded much in his inventory. He does have another free sample book, so I am going to take that. Thank you very much. And then, do I need to upgrade my bow? Can I actually compare that with what I'm using now? Doesn't seem like I can. A war bow, which has a bit of electricity added, apparently. Now we have a sharpshot bow. Slow firing but highly accurate bow is best used for long range combat when target precision is critical. Can be modified. I think the bow will probably be enough, but do I want to buy another bow? I don't think I need to.
All right then, time to go.
Good luck tomorrow, Aloy.
Thank you. Thank you, Karst. So, free sample box, let's open that up. And there we go. True Blaze, faster health pack, and resist freeze potion. It's something at least. Thank you very much.
What harm can they do?
Oh, look at those costumes.
In a moment, we shall bless the proving. But first, we have guests to welcome.
Jezza.
For 2 years, we have been at peace with Akarja. It is time to restore our bonds of trade with Meridian. These envoys come to us under a banner of peace.
These guys look fancy.
Peace.
An look at the clothes he's wearing.
Of gratitude, killers and slavers! Yeah! Sun King of
killers and slavers!
Hey! Luminance hold your fruit, Nora Faithful. Hold your fruit. Now, I'm Azaram, not Karja. So I'll put it to you straight. The 13th Sun King was a murderous bung. Oh, he was. He's a tyrant and a monster. Raided my tribe for blood sacrifice, just like yours. My own sister was taken. I hated the Karja. But the 13th king is dead. 2 years now. Who killed him? The 14th.
Yeah.
Not because he lusted for power, but because someone had to put an end to his father's atrocities.
Yeah!
So that's a third tribe, and it looks like these guys are more advanced than the Nora tribe.
Straight from the lips of the 14th king. So please, can't you lend him your ears?
Seems like they can. Thank you, Aaron.
An enunciation of gratitude written by the hand of Sun King Avad, 14th luminance of the Radiant Line.
Oh, what is that?
On the eve of your proving, unknown device detected.
Possibly a focus or other personal device with a secure network connection. Talk to the man, okay?
Just like mine.
Hello?
You're the only other person I've ever seen wearing a focus. Where did you get yours?
What? A Nora? Wearing one of these? That's impossible. Your tribe fears the old places, forbids them.
Who says I'm like other Nora?
Why, I guess you're not. If you've gone delving in the ruins of the metal world.
What's wrong?
Apologies. A malfunction.
Oh, yeah,
this is orange.
We're making friends with locals, are we?
I'll come back.
Wait.
No, we'll talk later. Have to go.
Whoa. What the hell is going on?
I guess he's more hungover than I thought. Hey, you got the same trinket that Olin has on his head. Since when did those become fashionable?
His name is Olin? Who is he? And where did he get one of these?
Olin and Erend.
He's just a scrounger with friends in high places. Now, he spends half his time digging for artifacts, the other half drinking or dicing. As for the trinket, well, I guess he dug it up somewhere. Just a weird old jewel he sticks on his face. I mean, no offense, it looks great on you.
Yeah, you're a real charmer. quite a speech. Nice
I've
armor.
Never seen armor like yours before.
You've never seen Vanguard steel? Now let me introduce you. Ring-locked, impact-protected, sturdy enough to choke a sawtooth. It has to be. The Vanguard of the Sun King's best. Life-takers and machine-breakers to a one.
The Vanguard.
You might even give a Nora warmaid like you more trouble than she can handle.
So
with all that metal to slow you down? I doubt it.
Yeah, hard to say. From where I'm standing, looks like a pretty even match.
Well, I'm glad you're making this an even match.
I thought your friend was going to go down in a hail of fruit, but you really calmed the crowd.
Thanks. I wasn't sure I could do it. The Nora is still pissed with the Karja about the Red Raids, and who can blame them?
Okay, the Red Raids.
I wanted to ask you something else.
If you want. But I'll also be around after that blessing thing, if that'd be a better time to talk.
Not really sure.
I
Red
never
Raids.
Heard anything about Red Raids growing up. What were those?
Your tribe was in war and you didn't even know? Were you kept hidden away? Did you have overprotective parents or something?
No parents.
I grew up as an outcast, shunned by the tribe.
Oh, yeah, I've heard the Nora do that. That seems cruel, if you ask me.
So that confirms that it's not a habit
but
in other tribes.
An outcast knows about the derangement of the machines, right? How they get deadlier every year? Well, the mad Sun King figured if he spilled enough blood to the Sun God, it would calm the machines. Didn't work.
Yeah, that was a really bad idea,
but for
probably.
For years, he raided the tribes and took captives for sacrifice. My sister among them. The Nora put up a good fight, but lives were lost.
That is terrible. Wow, there's a lot of options right now. How did it end?
What happened? How did it all end?
So the one king,
the Mad King's own son, united Karja rebels with Asaram freebooters. And together we did the impossible, took back Meridian and killed the crazy old king. So now the son sits on the throne and it's a big improvement. Under Avad, there's no more sacrifices, no more slavery. People from all tribes are welcome in Meridian now, even Nora exiles. You really should come visit.
I should start making notes. So that was King Avad, and he's the king of the Karja. And this guy is Arid. He's part of the Vanguard who protect the king, and he's from Asaram.
Who's Asaram?
Oh, that's my tribe, far to the northwest. We're good at three things. Arguing, working steel, and brewing.
And freebooters. What are those?
I guess you could say we were mercenaries. You know, warriors for pay. Except a lot more loyal than that makes us sound. Avad couldn't have taken down his father without our metal and muscle. And now some of us serve proudly as his personal vanguard.
Sounds nice. And so your sister
was
killed.
My sister was taken captive and sacrificed. That's terrible.
Captive, where I'm from, they
yes.
call that murder.
Sacrificed? No. It takes more than a few Karja to finish Ursa. She got away, and now she's my captain. Captain of the entire Vanguard, favored by the Sun King himself.
How did she
Ooh,
survive?
Interesting.
Well, that's a story, all right, but it takes a while to tell. Maybe another time over a drink or three?
Oh, chicka wow wow.
Or just come to Meridian and meet her yourself. I think you'd like each other. You're both rather, direct.
Yes, indeed. The arrangement of the machine. So we know from the story that the matriarch told us that the machines are getting angrier and angrier by the year.
You said the
so.
Machines have been getting more dangerous every year.
Yeah, I don't have to tell you that, right?
First I've heard of it.
Oh, I'm sorry. I just assumed everyone knew. Well, the way I hear it, 15, 20 years ago, the machines weren't always pissed off like they are now. When a hunter came at them, they'd spook and run.
Well, I'm usually the one shooting first,
so... it was hard to take them down, but not dangerous, so long as he was smart enough to jump out of the way. But then the derangement starts up and everything changes. Now, when a hunter fires a shot, the machines snarl and charge right at him.
Well, with good reason, I assume.
A few more years pass, and they start attacking people on sight. Going anywhere becomes a major risk.
I kind of feel like they just learned to attack us.
Entirely new kinds of machines start showing up. Bigger, meaner, and heavily armed.
Like the Sawtooth.
Yeah, 10 years ago, that one. But every couple of years or so, something worse comes along. Believe me.
So what's making it happen?
And no one knows. And the machines, well, they aren't telling.
Interesting. Why is that not grayed out? Just asked about it. And then the Karja?
If the Karja have such a cruel history, how did you end up serving them?
The last king and his men were butchers. But the new king wants peace. There's nothing cruel about that. Besides, the Karja don't just fight, they build. But take Meridian. Next to it, everything else is just a bunch of sticks and stones.
So Meridian is a very big city by the sounds of it.
Just how big is Meridian? What's it like?
Where do I even start? My tribesmen are masters of the forge, the best tinkers in the world. But when it comes to building, the Karja have us beat. The city soars over a canyon with more bridges than the Nora have roads and buildings tall as mountains. And across the valley stands the spire, like a blade thrust into the sky reflecting the sun. You really owe it yourself to see it. So consider that a challenge. Or an invitation.
Okay then, you're getting really friendly with me, aren't you? Also, Rami,
I want to ask you about something you said before.
Ask away.
Ask away. So yeah, the last thing we can talk about is
Olin.
What else
do you know about Olin?
Is he really that interesting? I'm starting to get jealous. Well, he scours the wilds for ruins, digs up stuff, and sells it to nobles. When he's not scrounging, he's scouting. Exactly the skills you want the man guiding your expedition to have. I've known him for a few years. He's a loyal companion, cares for his family, holds his drink well enough. I like him, but besides that, not much to tell.
Okay. Yeah, we should go to the Blessing then.
I should make my way to the Blessing.
Yeah. Look, maybe I shouldn't say this, but it's obvious that you don't belong in this backwater.
I mean, you're
smart. You're obviously capable, and, well, I mean, look at you.
What are you talking about?
Stop trying to get in my pants.
All right, if you ever visit Meridian, look me up. I'll show you around, make introductions. It'd be a whole new life, if you want it. Anyway, I have to go to that Blessing thing, too, so, see you around. Maybe?
Probably, Arendt. Probably. So thank you, Arendt, for that very detailed explanation. So now we're quite a bit wiser about this world. So there's, for now, there's three tribes. So the Osoram, the Karja, and the Nora tribe. The Osoram are most likely smiths. So blacksmiths and making weapons, mercenaries and the like. And then the Karja are more builders and the more kind of the merchant types. That was something I wanted to say. Now we need to head down apparently, but is there a safe point around here somewhere? Because I want to take a little break, but I can't do that without a fire. Oh, this where we came from? Feels like we came from over here. Yeah, okay, I'm just gonna head over here, back, and we're gonna take a little break. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give the talk to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye! Okay,